In this tutorial, I'll show you how to individually apply a gradient material onto an arrayed set of meshes. Let's create a circle. If you don't see the circle in the menu, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. We need 6 vertices. I'll extrude it upward and fill the faces. Let's use 2 array modifiers. Check out what happens here. I'm unchecking the relative offset setting on the second array modifier, and the first modifier comes up out of nowhere. At this point, I thought I was working on the second modifier, but I was actually working on the first one for some reason. I found disabling the relative offset on the second modifier somehow switched the modifiers. If you encounter an odd bug like this, please undo and just try again. Now we have a complete mesh. Here is a simple gradient material. Please scale to spread the gradient over the entire mesh. We can also move the material's location like this. How do we apply the same material into individual meshes? There's a way to do so, and that is to apply all modifiers and separate the meshes by loose parts. In edit mode, type A to select all, and P to separate by loose parts. That's how we apply the gradient materials into arrayed set of meshes individually. Let's randomly move them on the Z axis. I'll use the sky texture. Looks like the transparent background is showing. Let's create a ground plane and apply the same material. I'll use the composite nodes. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.